Hello, my dear kids. Very good evening. This is Sundar Ravindranathan here. Hey guys, what's happening? How is everybody? Hi, Padmashree. Hi, Suhani. Yashashvi. Guys, first of all, before I move forward, a very, very happy Janmashtami to every one of you. I hope you are enjoying the occasion. Yup. Hello, Bhumika. Hi, Sivakarthigeyan. Hello, Zainab. Lovely to see all of you. We are starting a brand new chapter today. The chapter is Kingdoms, Kings and an Early Republic. I am awesome, Nirmal Das. Thank you so much. Hi, Surendra, Soumya. So guys, you know what? If at all we need to know, when people were born in the earlier ages, if you look at ancient history, everyone was same, right? Everyone was born as a human being. Suddenly, how this divide of rich, poor, people, kings, all these kind of divides, how did they come into picture? How were rulers got created? How did they evolve? How did kings come into picture? Very curious to understand that, right? When everyone is equal, suddenly, how come a few people became more powerful and they became kings and rulers? Is that a right question that I'm asking? Hi, Radhika Soni. Shivalingappa, hi, beta. Aradhanath. Hi, Asra Ansari. So, that is what we're going to see today. How did, you know, the concept of kings, rulers, all those things, and who were these initial kings? What were the Janapadas, Mahajanapadas? A lot of things we are going to see today. So watch out. Alright, let's move on. Hello, Nigam. Guys, the schedule for this week. Let me hide my screen. Have a quick look at the schedule for this week. So today we are dealing with part 1 of the new chapter, Kingdoms, Kings and Early Republic. Tomorrow the same chapter, part 2. And then from Wednesday onwards, it will be grade 7. Okay, we have completed the chapter Air, so grade 7 ka boomerang will happen. And then new chapter, Women Change the World. Another chapter on Friday, Towns, Traders and Craftspersons. So this is how this week is structured. Quite exciting. Lot of learnings, lot of interesting stuff. Okay. So let us move on. Yeah. Let me bring myself back. Okay, guys, in case you do not know anything about Vedantu Young Wonders, what this channel is all about. This is a channel for 6th, 7th and 8th grade students. It has got academic content, non-academic content. See, as a student, what do you need? You want support for your studies. You want the best teachers to teach you. Both these things are there. But in your free time, what do you look for? You look for interesting information to play, interesting information to learn. You also look for something for your career and your personal development. Everything non-academic is also there in the same channel. So do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Hi Goyal Dimesh. Thank you. Happy Krishna Jayanti Sivagartiye. Alright, so guys, let's start with the fun fact as usual. All of you know this sleeping bird, right? Albatross. Albatross is a kind of a seabird, right? And it's also called as a sleeping bird. You know what? When it is flying, it can sleep. At 25 miles per hour, it sleeps. Would you believe that? Hi, Ritik Raj. Hi, Komal. His screen is very clear. Yeah, I don't know what is the issue. Please refresh your page, okay? Right, let's begin. Yeah, look at that. The bee is saying, let's begin. Alright, it's time. Guys, today, Kingdoms, Kings and an Early Republic. How did this got formed? So, we are going to see how some people suddenly became more powerful and became rulers. One, what is a Janapada? Alright, and what is called as a Mahajanapada? And were there taxes at that time? before what, 2000, 2500 years ago, we will see all these things. Ready? Guys, is my screen clear for all of you? Is that a yes or a no? Everyone says yes. Nirmal, I think you got to check it out, beta. So guys, how some men became rulers? See, if you look at it, almost like as I said, 2500, almost 3000 years ago, people were almost, everyone is kind of equal only. And slowly some people were recognized as rajas, because a few people will be, you know, strong. It could be physically, and sometimes it could be slowly they are smart in, you know, with their intelligence, they acquire more wealth, right? And sometimes they perform a lot of, you know, big sacrifices. These people were called as rajas. When did this happen? Almost 3000 years ago. So Ashwamedha Yaga or horse sacrifice, it was one ritual, right, where a horse will be let loose. It will go country after country, region after region. By whom? Alright, it will be guarded by that so-called Raja's security people. That horse, his rather, Raja's horse will be let loose. Okay? And if the horse gets into a kingdom of another Raja, and that Raja is not allowing the horse, he's stopping it, then that means there is a battle between these two Rajas. However, if the horse of a Raja is entering another kingdom, and that Raja, whoever is there in that kingdom, is allowing the horse to pass, that means that king is accepting the rule of the Raja who owns. Okay, and while performing these sacrifices, the person who accepted the rule of the Raja, that king will be called for the sacrifice. He will be a part of the ritual. Are you guys clear? Mohammed Israel, menti nahi hoga bhaiya, abhi shuru kar diya. Okay, the session itself started now. So everyone is clear, right? So this is what is Ashwamedha Yaga. So if the Raja is stopping it, there is a battle between these two. If the Raja is not stopping, allowing it to pass, he accepts the rule of the Raja who owns the horse. Cool? So the Raja who sent that horse, generally, he is considered to be very powerful. Alright, and all of them, for the sacrifice, they bring a lot of gifts. Like they go for a ceremony or a function, right? So in these rituals, as I said, the Raja is a central figure. The other Rajas who are invited, they come, they are merely spectators who will watch. Okay? The priest will be performing the ritual, and ordinary people, Vaishyas, they also bring gifts. But remember, the lowest caste at that time, you whom we call as Shudras, they were not allowed. Alright? They were not allowed to attend these rituals. I hope you guys are clear. Now, why should I speak about this? Please remember, I want to highlight to you how suddenly some people became rulers. At that point in time, initially, suddenly, you know, a few people were recognized as Rajas. And Rajas, to make themselves more powerful, they perform these kind of Ashwamedha Yaga kind of sacrifices. Are you understanding, Shailendra? Everyone? So that's how they make themselves more powerful. When they send a horse, the horse goes kingdom after kingdom. Whichever kingdom is stopping it, there is a battle. If the kingdom is accepting it, that means they are ready to accept the rule of the Raja. This way, the Raja who sent the horse becomes more and more powerful as a king, as a ruler. Cool? Hello, Paulomi. Hi. So now, this is how rulers evolve. Now, let's speak about a different type of rulers called Janapadas. Janapadas, remember, the Rajas who performed these sacrifices, right? They were called as Rajas of Janapadas. They are not just called Janas. Janas mean people. Jana means generally people. Janapada, alright, Janapada means the land where Jana has settled down. And these Rajas were called as the Raja of the Janapadas. They are called as the king of that land. Clear? See, tribe, who said Apurva, you can call it a tribe, but you can call it by multiple meanings. At that time, the concept of tribes and all is not there. But it is something similar. Okay? Guys, once again, for your information, I would want to repeat. Everyone was kind of equal. A few people were suddenly started getting recognized as Rajas. These Rajas do a lot of things, like performing sacrifices, right? They are like very strong, and in these sacrifices, they portray themselves as more and more powerful. During these sacrifices, like Ashwamedha Yaga, they are the center of attraction. All other Rajas who are invited, they are just merely spectators. Clear? Now, once they have complete the sacrifice, they are recognized as Rajas of these Janapadas, a region. Janapada is nothing but a land where Jana lives. Jana means people. So these Rajas, after completing the sacrifices, they are called as Raja of the Janapadas. Ashwamedha Yaga is a sacrifice, it's a ritual, where a horse is sent after king, you know, it is let loose. The horse travels to multiple places. If it goes to another kingdom and that king stops, there is a battle between that king and the king who owns the horse. If the king where the horse of the kingdom where the horse entered, if he allows it, that means he is ready to accept the rule of the Raja who owns the horse. Clear? Cool. Now coming back. Guys, a lot of Janapadas, alright, settlements of Janapadas were excavated by archaeologists. Where? Purana Kila in Delhi. Hastinapura near Meerut, okay, Athranji Khera near Itta. Multiple places, we have strong evidence that these Janapadas were existing. What are they, sir? What did they excavate? They excavated, they identified that, people lived in huts. They were rearing cattle as well as other animals. They were growing crops like rice, wheat, barley, pulses, sugarcane, sesame and mustard. And they also know pottery. They created earthen pots. Okay, one special type of pottery called as painted grayware was also done. You look at that picture. That is painted grayware. Clear? So, there are a lot of evidences that these Janapadas were existing. And there was a civilization in place where people knew how to live. Alright, they knew how to do agriculture, they knew how to build a hut, they knew how to rear cattle. This is the point that you need to remember. So, I hope you have a great idea about what is a Janapada. Janapada is a settlement where people live. Right? And Rajas who perform these sacrifices, they are called as Rajas of the Janapadas. They start ruling the region. Cool? Hi, Jaitra. Edit Flex, hi. So guys, Mahajanapada. All of you know what is a Janapada. If a Raja is owning a Janapada after those sacrifices and stuff, sometimes when he becomes more wealthy, more powerful, the Janapada becomes a Mahajanapada. Mahajanapada has a capital. See, look at this. About 2500 years ago, some Janapadas became more powerful and more important. And they were called as Mahajanapadas. And Mahajanapada generally, in general, mostly, they had a capital city. Alright, and there were forts around the capital. Forts, huge walls of wood for security purpose. Right, so forts are, they were fortified. Mahajanapadas, the capital city was fortified with wood, brick or stone. Exactly, Magadha is a great example. So forts were built, number one, for security. People were afraid that other kings might come and attack them, number one. Number two, rulers want to show their might. They want to show how rich and powerful they are by building large, tall and impressive walls around their cities. Number three, the land and the people living inside the fortified area could be controlled more easily by the king. If you inside, whenever there is a fort, inside the fort, whatever that is there, you have better control, correct? Right. So, such huge walls also show their engineering mindsets. All right, it requires a lot of planning. Cool. So guys, now you know ruler, how people, some men became rulers. Now you know what is a Janapada and when Rajas are accepted as Rajas of Janapadas. Now you also know what are Mahajanapadas, right? We all know, you know, archaeologists excavated these Janapadas in different places also. Guys, till this, are you clear? Shall I move on? Give me a yo if you're clear. Apurva, it is built. They built temples. Yeah, great. So, apart from this, these Rajas who are so powerful, they started maintaining. Slowly, it started building up, guys. They started creating an army, they created forts, they built forts, they had armies, soldiers were paid salaries, right? And they had also currencies. These currencies were in the form of punch marked coins. Right, look at that picture. Punch marked coins. Are you able to see? Now, right now you have this 2 rupee coins, right? 5 rupee coins and all. This is the kind of coins that were there 2500 years ago. Okay, so all of you know what is Janapada, right? Homemade recipe. Janapada is a settlement where people were living. And there were Rajas slowly started coming in for these Janapadas by performing sacrifices, becoming powerful. So with time, a few Janapadas became more powerful and important. Suddenly, for different reasons, could be for business, that is commerce, alright, for anything. Such Janapadas were started getting called as Mahajanapadas. Okay? And these Mahajanapadas are known for having capitals. They had forts, armies were there, soldiers had, the government was formed properly. Even currencies were there. Now you understand what are Mahajanapadas, all of you? Okay, guys. I am sure now that the Olympics is over, I just want to ask you this. Have you observed sportsmen? Do you know if you are a cricketer, if you want to pray for international cricket for India, do you know what all you need to do? Where you need to start? Come on. Where you need to start? My question is, if you as a cricketer, if you love cricket and you want to play for India, where you need to start? Many are of silver. Yeah, you need to start locally, right? By playing local games for local clubs. And from clubs, you have to play to the district level. From the district level, you have to play to state level. From state level, you play national level. National level, Ranji Trophy. After that, you play international level. Now, my question is, if you are playing for a local club, you can stop there, right? Why do you want to go till international level? Guys, are you understanding my question? My question is very simple. You are playing for a local club, you can stop there. Why should you try applying or going in for district, state, national, international? It is because you want to show your capability, right? Because you know that you are a very good sports person in that sport. The same way, my dear kids, all of you are students. If you want to show how good you are, if you want to prepare yourself and show how good you are in math and science or even English, there is a great opportunity for you to participate in Junior Olympiads, grade 6. It's a lovely news for all of you. As I take you through this, you are going to be amazed. What are Olympiads? They give you an early exposure to the, an advanced level of understanding of concepts you will know where you stand, how competitive you are. All right, and you will also prepare for national level exams like, NTSC, multiple things. And subsequently, you will also get prepared for exams, academic exams like NEET, JEE, etc. Your problem solving skills and analytical thinking skills will improve. Sir, shall I directly write? You can write, but obviously for everything you need to prepare, right? That is when, even if it is Sachin Tendulkar, he prepares. He practices a lot like that. Please remember, you need to prepare yourself. Okay? And as a result, you have an opportunity to get international recognition, cash scholarships, medals, and so on. The entire world will know you. Guys, there are multiple Olympiads. Olympiads are competitive exams for this. There are multiple Olympiads. National Science Olympiad, run by Science Olympiad Foundation, SOF. International Math Olympiad, Science Olympiad Foundation. Right? National Science Talent Search Examination, UIMO, IOM. This is for mathematics, IOS for science. These are the dates when these exams happen. Right? Guys, trust me, you have a great opportunity now. You know why? So these are, look at the gifts and the prizes. 50,000 rupees and an international gold medal. And a certificate for outstanding performance. Similarly, 25,000, third rank, 10,000, zonal level, 1,000 rupees each. So many prizes are there, guys. And you know what? This is for NSTSC. I want you to go through all these things slowly, gradually. 2 lakh cash prize, 2 lakh cash prize if you are an NSTSC topper. Right? Similarly, UIMO, okay, it's a unified IMO, guys. UIMO means, don't worry. So again, 2 lakh cash prize. IOM and IOS. You getting it, guys? Olympiads are so good. So good. Great opportunity for you to prepare yourself and showcase. You can always say, sir, right now, I don't think I'm that competitive. Here it is, you have a chance to study from the best teachers, because Vedantu has come out with Vedantu Junior Olympiad Clash Course. Everything in one package. Okay? So they will give you part tests, you will know where you stand nationally, mock tests will be conducted, slowly they will prepare you, we will prepare you in fact. Okay? And you can ask any number of questions inside the class, similar to the pro. And you can get solutions for that as well. Key concepts. Guys, you know what? When you prepare, you will see that even most of your syllabus also get covered. Your normal school syllabus also gets covered here. That's the best part. So, look at this. So many classes, 80 plus. Math, science and aptitude covered. 10 part tests, 5 full tests. 5 All India mock tests, 70 assignments. Motivation sessions to keep you competitive and inspired. Parent teacher meetings will also be there. So many, guys. Any idea how much this course is going to cost you? Complete preparation for almost like 6 months. Any idea how much the course is going to cost you? Come on, give it a try. You have seen all what is it going to happen, right? Come on. Someone is saying 10,000, someone is saying 5,000. Yeah? 2,700 after the coupon code. Everything, guys, everything for so many Olympiads. My goodness. You will never get this kind of an opportunity, because it's not just for Olympiads. Because indirectly you're preparing yourself, you're strengthening your academics also. Guys, this offer is not going to be there for a long time. Quickly make use of it. Alright, 2700 rupees overall for everything in one package. So you will see that Sandeep Sharma sir, Renu Garg ma'am, Malvika Soni ma'am will be teaching you. We already have so many Olympiad achievers, guys, make use of it. Because when we conducted, initially Vedantu, all of you know that Vedantu did not conduct Olympiad preparation. But once we did few batches, you know, we understood this is something which every student should know. And that's the reason we exclusively launch a course for this, a crash course. Okay? So these are the batches. The Olympiads are starting on 14th of September for 6th grade and 6th of September for 7th and 8th grade. And normal Vedantu Pro batches are starting on the other dates. And for foundation, NEET or JEE, 30th August it is. That is tomorrow, today. Roasting Baba. Guys, before we jump into a mentee, the final. Now you know how some men became rulers. You also know what are Janapadas. Archaeologists, you know, identified the different ways, you know, to show that people at that time, 2500 years ago, they lived a very civilized life. They knew how to do agriculture, they knew how to rear animals, cattle, right? So now it's time, you also know what is a Janapada and a Mahajanapada, right? Now it's time to know about taxes. So the rulers of Mahajanapadas were building huge forts, I told you, right, already. Mahajanapada had a capital city, forts, soldiers and army, a standing army as well. Okay, but they need to pay the soldiers, right? For that, they started collecting taxes to maintain armies. Taxes on crops were there. Usually, out of, you know, entire produce, 1/6 was collected as tax. And this tax which was collected, 1/6, is called as bhaga or share. Bhaga means a part of it. Okay, there were taxes even on craftspersons. Okay, generally taxes need not be money alone. Sometimes even it could be in the form of labor. Ooh, guys, are you clear with this? It's not bhaga, bhaga. Bhaga means part, a part of it. Okay, so even people who were herding animals, they were expected to pay taxes in the form of animal produce or sometimes animals themselves. So taxes on goods, whatever goods were bought or sold, trade taxes were also there. Look at, guys, Mahajanapada is so important. You have to look at this. So they have so many things, right? They had a capital, they had a fort, they had armies, they had tax systems. Hunter-gatherers, they also had to produce, you know, provide forest produce to the Raja as taxes. Okay, time for a homework. Ready, all of you? Hey guys, till this, are you clear, every one of you? Come on, let me know. Everyone clear? If you're clear, give me a yo. If you're not clear, tell me a no. There are so many people who say, sir, I'm not clear. Let me take you guys quickly through this now. Look at this, guys. How some men became rulers. Number one, first, when everyone was there, there were a few people, some men who were recognized as Rajas. Alright, they became Rajas by performing big sacrifices. Alright, one sacrifice is called Ashwamedha or horse sacrifice, where the horse of that king or the kingdom, alright, the Raja, was let loose. If that horse gets into the kingdom of another Raja and that Raja stops it, then he is not ready to accept the rule of the Raja of the horse. But if that, you know, king allows the horse to pass in his kingdom, he is ready to accept the rule of the Raja who owns the horse. Okay. And if he accepts it, then he is invited for the ritual by the Raja who owns the horse. Cool? Okay. Now, Janapadas. Guys, Janapadas are these Rajas who perform big sacrifices. They were called as Rajas of these Janapadas, of a region. All right, they are not just Jana. Jana means just people. Rajas of Janapada means a land, a region. These people became rajas of a region. Clear? Two, archaeologists identified a lot of Janapadas at Purana Kila, Hastinapura, Atranjikera. They identified people who were living in huts. They knew how to do agriculture. They knew how to rear cattle. They also knew pottery, and specifically something called as painted graveware. You see in the picture? Mahajanapadas, some Janapadas became more and more powerful. They became more important. They were called as Mahajanapadas. And Mahajanapadas, as I already told you, they are regions which were more powerful, which had forts for security, which had standing armies, which collected taxes, which had a currency. Are you guys clear? All of you? So these are the special aspects that we need to note about Mahajanapadas. Okay, cool. Now coming to taxes. I hope everyone is clear now. Everyone? So in Mahajanapadas, taxes were also levied on almost everything. From farmers, from herders. Even if you are a craftsperson, taxes are levied. Even if you are a laborer, taxes are levied even in the form of labor. Cool? If you are a trader, taxes were levied on whatever you sold or whatever you bought. Okay. Guys, I hope now you are clear. Everyone. I have done a quick recap also, complete recap. Kings built the fort Ritik for two reasons. One, for protection. Number two is they have better control. And in fact, three is to show to the world how powerful they are. Cool? Okay guys, homework for today. Match the following: Magadha, Hastinapura, Bhaga. Taxes, Mahajanapada, Janapada. Clear? Okay, I hope match it, put the right answer in your comment section. First three I will recognize. Guys, it's time for a mentee. I want all of you to open a separate browser window and type www.menti.com, M-E-N-T-I, menti.com. And it will ask you for the code. Type the code 67751568. I repeat the code 67. Go to menti.com, the website www.menti.com. And it will ask you, please enter the code 67751568. Anshu, we will come to that beta separately. Hi Amritanshu, thank you. Guys, moving on to your mentee now. I see only 40 of you have joined. Quickly, there is not much time. 30 seconds max. Faster, faster, faster. All right, 10 more seconds. Here we go. All right, guys. First question on your screens. The Ashwamedha sacrifice, it is that of a horse, a cow, a bull or a goat. Horse, a cow, a bull or a goat. Come on guys, super simple question, right? I know you guys are going to nail this. Horse it is, of course. All of you get it, bang on. So Kushbu, Archana, Arbin, Arpit, Akshay, top 5. CBSC, Suresh, Jivika, Sanchi and Chinu, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Question number 2, 3 more to go. Here comes the second question. Dash were not allowed to take part in the rituals after the Ashwamedha. Vaishyas, priests, women, Shudras. Some one section among this, they were not allowed to take part in the rituals. It is in general, it's not even after Ashwamedha, frankly. Hi Shreya. So how many of you chose option D? Shudras. Shudras were, you know, looked upon as a downtrodden society. They were not allowed. Kushbu, Arpit, Suresh, Sanvi and Malu. Top 5. Devil, Aditi, high astrophysicist, Magnet, Aditya. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Question number 3. Here it is. On your screens. The two words that constitute Jana Pada. Jana means what? Pada means what? Women and foot, citizens and foot, men and hand, goats and rajas. I have spoken about what is Jana so many times. Not bad. Jana means people, the citizens. Foot. Pada. Pada means what? Pada means foot. Kushbu, Astro, Devil, Sanvi and Indian Armed Forces. Top 5. Abhishek, Magnet, Abhay, Mars and Vedanta student. New Vedanta student. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hey guys, question number 4, just one more to go. Be ready. Here it is. 1/6 of the produce was taken as tax from which place? 1/6 of the produce was taken as tax from farmers, hunter-gatherers, craftspersons, traders. 1/6 was taken from some one among this. So simple. How many of you say option A? Farmers. Yes, it is. Hey guys, looks like Kushbu is still and well at the top. Followed by astrophysicist, Sanvi, Indian Armed Forces, Devil, top 5. Abhishek, Magnet, Chico, Pramukh and new student. Final question, the decider on your screen, now. Kawaii, we don't have an option for top 20 beta. So guys, capital cities were fortified with huge walls of, made of wood, brick or stone. Is it true or false? For the Mahajanapadas, capital cities were there. They had forts built with huge walls made of wood or brick or stone. true or false? How many of you chose option A? True. Almost every one of you. Super. Hey guys, who's gonna win now? Is it Khushbu? Yes, looks like it is. Khushbu, astrophysicist in Devil Indian Armed Forces. Khushbu, congratulations, beta, great job done. Congratulations, astrophysicist, Devil. Who is that? And Abhishek, top 5 guys, magnet brains. Who is that? Not able to see. Prem, everyone in the leaderboard, guys, congratulations. Many congratulations to all of you. Starting from Khushbu till new student. Guys, there could have been so many of you who could not get into the leaderboard, but you got right answers. Congratulations, all of you as well. Hey guys, now I hope you know how slowly some kings among the, from the as normal people in the society, suddenly they started evolving. And now you also knew how, right? You all of you know. Okay, by the way guys, click on the link in the, you know, in the comment section to take advantage of all that I spoke, the courses, Vedantu's courses. Okay, and yes, if you're pretty clear about the first part, what I dealt with today regarding how men became rulers, right? And regarding Janapadas, Mahajanapadas, and taxes, all put together, hit the like button and let me know you liked it, guys. Regarding Magadha and all, we will deal in the next session, tomorrow. And don't forget to subscribe if you have not done that and if you are new to Vedantu Young Wonders. My dear kids, thank you so much for watching the session. I hope you liked it and you're clear, more importantly. Hit the like button, let me know you liked it. Thank you so much. I will see you tomorrow. Until then, bye-bye. See you.